te cubra con su gracia, hasta mil generaciones, tu familia y tus hijos y los hijos de tus hijos, que te cubra con su gracia, hasta mil generaciones, tu familia y tus hijos y los hijos de tus hijos, que te cubra con su gracia, hasta mil generaciones, tu familia y tus hijos y los hijos de tus hijos, que te cubra con su gracia, hasta mil generaciones, tu familia y tus hijos y los hijos de tus hijos, su presencia te acompañe. Donde quiera que tú vayas, que te llene, te rodee, va contigo, de mañana y de noche, en tu entrada y salida, en tu llanto de alegría, Él te ama, Él te ama, Él te ama, Él te ama, Él te ama.
Te ama, Él te ama, Él te ama. The Son of God was laid in darkness. words for him, then I don't have them. You see, my brain has not yet reached a point where it can form a thought that could adequately describe the greatness of my God. And my lungs have not yet developed the ability to release a breath with enough agility to breathe out the greatness of his love. And my voice, you see, my voice is so inhibited, restrained by human limits, that it's hard to even send a praise up. You see, if there are words for him, then I don't have them. My God, his grace is remarkable. Mercies are innumerable. Strength is impenetrable. He is honorable, accountable, favorable. He's unsearchable yet knowable. Indefinable yet approachable. Indescribable yet personal. He is beyond comprehension, further than imagination. Constant through generations, King of every nation. But if there are words for him, then I don't have them. You see, my words are few. And to try and capture the one true God using my vocabulary would never do. But I use words as an expression of worship to a Savior who is both worthy and deserving of my praise. So I use words. My heart extols the Lord, blesses his name forever. He has won my heart, captured my mind, and is bound them both together. He has defeated me in my rebellion, conquered me in my sin. He has welcomed me into his presence, completely invited me in. He has made himself the object of my sight, flooding me with mercies in the morning, drowning me with grace in the night. But if there are words for him, then I don't have them. But what I do have is good news. For my God knew that man-made words would never do, for words are just tools that we use to point to the truth. So he sent his son, Jesus Christ, as the word, living proof. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For by him all things were created, giving nothingness formation. And by his word he sustains in the power of his name. For he is before all things, and over all things he reigns. Holy is his name, so praise him for his life. He persevered in strife, the humble Son of God becoming the perfect sacrifice. Praise him for his death, that he willingly stood in our place, that he lovingly endured the grave, that he battled our enemy, and on the third day rose in victory. He is everything that was promised. Praise him as a risen king. Lift your voice and sing, for one day he will return for us, and we will finally be united with our Savior for eternity. Eternity. So it's not just words that I proclaim, for my words point to the word, and the word has a name. Hope has a name. Joy has a name. Peace has a name. Love has a name. And that name is Jesus Christ. Praise his name forever.
Yeah. not for the cross. We thank you for the cross, Jesus. We just worship you tonight. Thank you, Lord, for your grace, your mercy, and your goodness in our lives, Lord. We just reach up to heaven tonight and just honor you. We bless your name. There's no one like you. What love. What love, Lord, that you thought of us. You chose to come to this earth to die for our sins so that we could live in freedom and grace and mercy and relationship with you, Jesus. There is no one like you, truly, in all the earth.
I believe you're my healer. will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. And I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, when my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, I'm
spoke the earth into existence. From creation that he loved, man was born of perfect image, made to be a friend of God, meant to dwell within his presence. Yeah, it's where we all belong. Holy Spirit,
oh,
It is not by my own earning to have the helper at my side. The gift was fully purchased when the Lamb was crucified. So now freely I can ask Him, for His blood has washed me clean. Let the dove of heaven rest upon the Christ in me. Let the dove of heaven rest upon.
Yeah. como los truenos. Recibe honor y gloria, poder y majestad. A ti, al único rey. Santo, 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 Dios todo.
te cubra con su gracia, hasta mil generaciones, tu familia y tus hijos y los hijos de tus hijos, que te cubra con su gracia, hasta mil generaciones, tu familia y tus hijos y los hijos de tus hijos, que te cubra con su gracia, hasta mil generaciones, tu familia y tus hijos, y los hijos de tus hijos, que te cubra con su gracia, hasta mil generaciones, tu familia y tus hijos, y los hijos de tus hijos, su presencia te acompañe. Donde quiera que tú vayas, que te llene, te rodee, va contigo, de mañana y de noche, en tu entrada y salida, en tu llanto de alegría, Él te ama, Él te ama, Él te ama, Él te ama, Él te ama.
Stone was rolled away. His perfect
Reached a point where it could form a thought that could adequately describe the greatness of my God. And my lungs have not yet developed the ability to release a breath with enough agility to breathe out the greatness of His love. And my voice, you see, my voice is so inhibited, restrained by human limits, that it's hard to even send a praise up. You see, if there are words for Him, then I don't have them. My God, His grace is remarkable. Mercies are innumerable. Strength is impenetrable. He is honorable, accountable, favorable. He's unsearchable yet knowable. Indefinable yet approachable. Indescribable yet personal. He is beyond comprehension, further than imagination. Constant through generations, King of every nation. But if there are words for Him, then I don't have them. You see, my words are few, and to try and capture the one true God using my vocabulary would never do. But I use words as an expression of worship to a Savior who is both worthy and deserving of my praise. So I use words. My heart extols the Lord, blesses His name forever. He has won my heart, captured my mind, and is bound them both together. He has defeated me in my rebellion, conquered me in my sin. He has welcomed me into His presence, completely invited me in. He has made Himself the object of my sight, flooding me with mercies in the morning, drowning me with grace in the night. But if there are words for Him, then I don't have them. But what I do have is good news. For my God knew that man-made words would never do, for words are just tools that we use to point to the truth. So He sent His Son, Jesus Christ, as the Word, living proof. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation, for by him all things were created, giving nothingness formation, and by his word he sustains in the power of his name. For he is before all things, and over all things he reigns. Holy is his name, so praise him for his life. The way he persevered in strife, the humble Son of God becoming the perfect sacrifice, praise him for his death. That he willingly stood in our place, that he lovingly endured the grave, that he battled our enemy and on the third day rose in victory. He is everything that was promised. Praise him as a risen king. Lift your voice and sing, for one day he will return for us and we will finally be united with our Savior for eternity. Eternity. So it's not just words that I proclaim, for my words point to the word, and the word has a name. Hope has a name. Joy has a name. Peace has a name. Love has a name. And that name is Jesus Christ. Praise his name forever.
In relationship with you, Jesus. There is no one like you, truly, in all the earth.